Guess what I'm doing. You saw those two. What the heck? Look at that. Now we're making a third. Too bad the show wasn't next week. Gotta get some lights, but that's where I was at, and then that's gonna be my little workshop.
G'day guys, welcome back to our channel, Star Wars Vault Unleashed. My name is Harris Goffey and I'm your host coming straight here from Sydney, Australia. Guys, today, episode 53, I can't wait for you guys to meet our next big vintage collector. You can probably see it on his background already. No need for explanation, but his name is Marc Rosenberg, aka also known as Adat Man from beautiful Buffalo in New York State. In United States. Marc, welcome to the channel, man. How are you?
Good. How are you doing?
Not too bad, buddy. Mate, thank you so much for jumping on. From the first time I saw you post, a little snippet of your video, of your collection there, it's like, whoa, I'm going to get this guy on the channel.
It's my baby, put it that way. It's a work in progress, I tell everybody. It's a work in progress.
Yeah, you know what? I know that we've had a bit of a chat before this. So if they're your babies, you've got 46 babies.
Yes. Not that many wives, but yes, a lot of babies, right?
Exactly. And I'm sure there's more to come as well. So anyway, Marc, look, for the audience, tell us a bit more about you.
My name is Marc Rosenberg. I'm a custodian for a school district. I'm married. I've got two kids. Live in Buffalo, New York, just outside of Buffalo, New York. Been a Star Wars guy, collector, kind of since I was a kid. I've got a few items, but I fell in love with Star Wars years ago, and it's just a passion of mine.
Awesome, man. And look, I think, again, we've had a chat offline about when you were born, when I was born, we kind of born around the same time. And, I think I told you that, my first movie, like cinematic experience, was Empire Strikes Back and yours was Jedi, right?
Mine was Return of the Jedi. I'm a little bit younger than you.
Just a tad, all right? And in terms of collecting, like, you know, back in the days, did you used to collect action figures and stuff?
I used to actually collect, I got a lot of G.I. Joes and stuff for that, like for Christmas. And as I got older and figured out what the flea market was about, and we've got one that's close here, about 5 miles from my house. When I was in high school and stuff like that, I started taking my G.I. Joes and trading for Star Wars stuff.
Awesome, man. And what, in terms of, what were those sort of first few action figures that you used to have back then, the old Star Wars ones?
The two that I have from my childhood, I remember three, but the two that I still have, I have a Stormtrooper and I have a R2-D2 sensor scope. And I had a Lando that I remember that you mailed away for like General Mills cereal or something like that.
Yeah.
And I don't know where that went. My parents had some house fire and stuff, and we had cleaned out the back room, and I found some of my other stuff, but I never found Lando. So,
right. But you still have Stormtrooper and R2-D2.
Yep. Still have that. I have them set aside, and those will remain in my collection.
Wow. That's super awesome, man. And tell me about your regaining, you know, your passion towards collecting. When did that happen, and how did it happen?
For me, I was a collector, you know, right along. And then for me, honestly, I've got a lot of tattoos. When like episodes 1, 2, and 3 came out, I got a ton of tattoos. I got 20 Star Wars tattoos, stuff like that.
Wow.
And then about 2008, it kind of died out for me. I'll be honest with you, the whole Disney thing taking over, it just didn't do it for me. You know what I mean? And, right. I had a buddy that, said, you know, you should check out this group on Facebook, the Imperial Commissary, the IC, and, you should check it out. And I had ran to him at the flea market, and I checked it out, and, I started pulling my stuff back out. I had a lot of stuff because we had moved. I had it over at my sister-in-law's house in her basement, just kind of in storage, really. I just had it in bins, and so it got me bringing it to our new house, you know, stuff like that, and pulling it out. Getting stuff that I forgot I had. I pulled out a whole box of vintage figures with all their weapons and everything. I forgot I had them, you know, like,
right.
You know, Luke Farm Boy, Taiwan with a saber and a tip and everything. Uh-huh. And, you know, like good figures and like nice figures and stuff. And I just forgot I had them because you just collect them and I put them in bins. And, you know, even now I can only display so much. So as you see behind right. me is my man cave / display in the basement, but you know, I do what I can and display here and there, and there's stuff throughout the house, you know, there's some stuff, but the wife likes me to kind of keep it, you know, not everywhere.
Of course,
my dog name was Leia. We just put our dog down a few weeks ago, but my dog's name was Leia. When I got married beach in Florida, we exited the beach the theme to Star Wars. She allowed that, she picked nice. That. It's always been kind of a part of, you know, me, you know, you can only hope your kids want to take on the same passion for it. One of mine, yes, the other one, probably not, but you know, we go, I want to say picking or hunting in the wild, you know, we go to like antique shops and this and that, my one son, and he loves doing it. So it's a father son thing. If he, you know, as long Absolutely. As he's doing liking it, I'll keep doing it with him, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. So it's probably safe to say that you know, your what you've got in the background is all the fault of your friend and Michael Havens from IC.
Yeah, that and a few others, but yeah, there's a few other guys, but yeah, my buddy, he's a local guy. We went to school together, Todd.
Right.
He's the one that kind of like relit the fire, to be honest with you. Sure. You know, and everybody, you know, some people like modern, some people like the vintage. I like the vintage, but yeah. Just Disney had a different twist on it. So, you know, certain people view, you know, like you and I grew up with that, I don't know, fuzzy little Ewoks, you know, and stuff like that. And it's just, you know, like some people say the teddy bears, but you know, like, you know, we went through all that and, you know, I just remember seeing Empire Strikes Back and just that Hoth scene was, it's just amazing to me, you know, in the snow, these giant walkers, and that's always stuck with me. I just always had a place in my heart for AT-ATs.
Absolutely. And that's kind of lead to my next question. Man, like, you know, I'm a big fan of AT-AT, right? I love my AT-ATs. In fact, I still got one box, like, you know, pretty much complete. But I've never seen a collection like yours, Mark. Like, seriously, that is just mind blowing, dude.
It's, I just piece them together. I, you know, if I can, or I like to trade, I like to trade with people. I don't, you know, I had a lot of, wax packs and wax boxes and stuff like that. I've traded a lot with people.
Right.
You know, like I'm always, there's a thing on the IC, it's Wanted Wednesday. I'll go on there and I post every Wednesday. I'm looking for AT-AT parts, or I'm looking, you know, for, AT-AT drivers and commanders loose. I've got a couple bins of them. I just keep collecting them and throwing them in the bin. It's just a thing, you know.
But what is it that got you, like, you know, kind of like you wake up one day and you go, okay, add out it is?
It's just, I don't know. I just always had a thing for that, you know, that opening.
Yeah.
In the Hoth scene where they're like, you know, we spotted Imperial Walkers, you know. And, I mean, there's just this thing coming. I mean, it's just an awful ship, you know.
Wow. Man, it's amazing. You know, I've kind of trying to stick to, you know, I try to control myself. Yes, I'm into, and I'm not as crazy as you. I always try to control myself, like in terms of I shouldn't get the second one, I shouldn't get the third one. But man, like, you know what you've done. And may I ask also, Mark, how long has it taken you to, you know, have this whole 46?
I actually didn't have a ton actually since I've joined the IC. When I joined that group, the Imperial Commissary, that's where it like really started picking up, and that was only like a year ago. But I mean, like, I've always had, you know, I built my first one. I'll show you when we go through it, but I built my first one a while back, and I had gotten a box, you know, off eBay, and it's just tough off eBay because everybody's trying to me, it's a lot of people trying to scam, you know, there's repro and stuff like that. And people are just looking to make a, we're in this group, you know, everybody, nobody likes repro. We're all trying to really, you know, help each other. And so I pieced one together off eBay. You know, I bought a chin gun here, a chin gun there, and did that one. And then I did another one. And then, you know, I had stuff. And then, so I started putting my display up. And then, you know, I went on there, and you can pick one up a week, or, you know what I mean? Like, you know, there's always people selling something. And then between that, I, you know, a couple of the other groups, there's Jawa Scrap Heap, Bespin Prime, you know, there's all these people that are just constantly, I never really realized until I got in the social media side of it, that there was really that much out there.
Yeah, true. You know, the community of Star Wars collectors are huge, man. And it's just ever growing, right? Especially with the new generation, you know, yes, you know, the younger generations, they might be into like that, you know, the prequel, and of course, the even younger ones, you know, they, you know, appreciate the Disney and the sequel and all that sort of stuff, but they, you know, their heart, you know, is always going to be vintage Star Wars,
right? As
so,
long as you like Jar Jar, as long as Jar Jar is not in the picture, we're all
can't be guaranteed. You can't guarantee that one, mate.
Right.
Yeah. Hey, so you talked about repro, right? So obviously, like, you know, the secondhand market out there, edits, like we're talking about what, $250 per piece, right? Let's say 250 all the way up to 400.
Yeah, I mean, boxed. You're probably better off buying a complete one, to be honest with you, if somebody's selling one. But, you know, like, if you can't, you just, I'm always looking for parts, put it that way. There's a, you know, there's a few parts that break on them that are, you know, up in the upper leg joint. There's a hub in there that a lot of times those break, and, you know, so I'll pick up one, and a couple legs are broke, and so I make it into parts. And then I try, when I get one, I try to keep all of the parts with the one I get, you know what I mean? Like, so if I get one and it's got the cheek, you know, the cheek guns and the side hatches, you know, you're going to make it complete with other ones, but I try to keep all the parts with the original ones. You know, I don't know if that makes sense. It's just something I've always done. You know, I try not to like get one and piece it all apart to make all these other ones. I keep that one together and then try and finish that one.
Sure. And, you know, obviously chin gun is the famous, missing pieces. When you buy edits in the secondhand market, and, do you want to tell us a bit more in terms, this is for the audience out there who are watching, if they are, you know, searching for a chin gun, for example, right? Or whatever parts it may be, in fact, how would you kind of tell the difference between repro versus non-repro?
A lot of times right off the bat is the clarity, you know, and like if they're crystal clear, I mean, these things are 40 years old, you know what I mean? So
exactly.
They're out there. There's clear ones that have sat in a box and never seen the light of day and stuff like that. But it's, you know, they're always going to start having that yellowing that all the Star Wars toys are pretty much known for. The big thing with the repros, they're usually an off color. A lot of times there's like rose colored ones out there. Good thing to look for is the EPM on their two raised parts where it lays in the piece. Make sure that that EPM, that that circle mark is there. Look for a good seam line. You know, if it's all wavy, usually it's repro because it's been made on a 3D printer or something like that. Right. And then the ends, when you flip up the J end, when you flip it up and look at it, you really want to see that it's molded. I mean, on a repro, you can really tell it's cut. I don't have any, usually because I try not to hang on to them, but I got a picture from a guy today that, you know, you can really, I was telling him, I mean, you know, to get a clear picture, you know, just kind of cup it in your hand and then have them looking up at you, and you can see that they're cut or, you know, if they're molded, you can tell. I mean, some of the stuff is good. There's actually one on eBay now they're selling, and they sell them with a yellow tint to them.
Wow.
So, yeah, I've seen it on there, and that's something to watch for. That's just why it's tough. Some of these Mercari and these side markets, they just sell repro. They don't, you know.
Sure.
It's good to stick with your Star Wars groups and the guys that are, you know, trying to look out for people and stuff like that.
Yeah. Who really knows their stuff, huh? The experts.
That's what I mean. You know, like, I got a pretty good, I'm comfortable where I can judge, you know, what's, I mean, nothing else. I've never seen anything else fake on an ad. It's usually just the chin guns. You know, but I got a few guys in the IC that I'll, you know, shoot a message to and, you know, hey, what do you think? Or I know what I think. What do you think? You know, kind of stuff like that. And second opinion never hurts. It's just like going to the doctor, you know?
Cool, man. That's awesome. Thanks for that advice. So guys, if you're watching and if you are looking for a secondhand edit in the market, just to make sure that it's not a repro, it's a true vintage original pieces. Feel free to reach out to Mark, the expert on edit, the edit man himself, or, you know, put some comments in the description field below. Tell us what you think. Mark, without further ado, man, I can't wait to see the Hoth background behind you. Come on, let's kill it with all those edits, man.
All right, well, let me unplug my phone and I'll spin it around here. There's from the view, the collection. So that's my very first edit. I pieced that together. This is my army. All of the drivers have their rifle, except for four. I'm four short in the back there. But so down here, you can see that's my original R2-D2. And my original stormtrooper there. That's a AT-AT Commander Clipper, graded in 80. I've got some stuff in there. That's my second ever AT-AT there. And then I've just got, you know, odds and ends too. That isn't necessarily Hoth related, you know, but I love my Imperials.
Hey, Mark, that is just super impressive, man. Like, my gosh, wow. Like, check out those, just the rows of those vintage goodness. My gosh. Hey, tell me about your second edit. What's the story with the sombrero?
The sombrero is actually, I won that. On the IC, there is a mystery mail call run by Mr. Right. Kirk Kemp and his wife, Shannon. They run it every Wednesday night. I was the 70th winner, and they were in Cozumel. And so my winnings was, that was part of my winnings, along with, here, I'll show you something. They had a mask that a guy hand makes. It's a pretty neat looking mask. I got that too. That was part of it. And then here, sorry, I don't mean to make you dizzy with the camera. You know, like here it is. There's that. They got that. It's all painted. I don't know if you can see it. There you go.
Yeah.
It was off. It's all been painted. I was the 70th winner of that. So
nice one.
They had it, you know, had it done. There you go. It's a mystery mail call, but so that's kind of that, you know, to put it into the collection. I kind of just put it on there and put the little sombrero on the edit there. Awesome. Here's the top shelf. I've got a couple Y wings. Stompers is my other 80s kind of collection thing, put it that way. There's some Dixie Cups back there. A few things from the ICC. ICCC is the convention that'll be in Nashville in April, run by Mr. Michael Havens. A few remembrance things. This is a man that passed away on the IC, that they called him the King. A guy sent me this, that's Hoth Leia, because it was my dog's was Leia, and we just put her to sleep a few weeks ago. And then this is the next shelf down. I've got some, you know, graded figures, graded drivers and commanders, but, you know, a few of the odds and ends, AT-ATs, micro machines. That was my first play set. I don't have a lot of other stuff. I do have a lot of the same things over and over again. A lot of people, you know, that's just what I like. That Droopy is a find when I said I went hunting with my kid, you know, to some of the places. It's an ongoing joke. The lady called him Buttface because she didn't know what his name was. So we laugh about that every time when we see him. You know, I got some R2s. And then on the bottom shelf down here, some biker scouts. Some of the AT-ATs have their chin guns, some don't. I slowly piece them together. I try to make it so that they have the same color at, you know, chin guns, because they yellow at different stages. And then I don't know why these little blue cases from Chewy Bandoliers. I like them. Got some of the original stickers there. There's my tub of drivers, and there's my tub of commanders. And then if I back up here, so these first two here are, I call them beater AT-ATs, but my kids actually play with them. When they play, I've got them so that they work. And my kids, you know, when they play with their Star Wars, they play with them. So I've got them on the floor. There's some parts. And then I've got a few mocks, Power Droid, Akbar, Guard, and Dengar. But I've got chin guns just, you know, here, because I'm trying to make them all the same color when I get them, you know, extra. I've got a whole bunch of stickers that I save them, you know, some of them are junk. That my tattoo guy did that. That's a hand-drawn Vader. I've got some, those are my baggies, of course, more Imperials. Now I'll go back, I'll go over to this side. This is the other rack. Up top, I've got a few mocks. I like I said, stompers, so I've got all these, the McDonald's stompers from the 80s. But I got this from the, there's a PIF, Pay It Forward group on the IC. You can say that you'll claim it, and then everybody, they kind of forward stuff in the mail, you know, to other people. You know, there's stuff like hidden in the background. As you see, I've got all like the cards and the star cases, but on my display too, I get all these Jabba Thrones and I just kind of throw them in, and they just kind of, to me, it just breaks it up, and then I just put figures on it. So, you know, I've got a pile of Emperors, and there's some Gaunt Droids, Power Droids, more Droopies. I'm trying to think in the back. I don't have much there. Down here, I've got a couple thermoses. I've got lunch boxes. I've got all that stuff. I just don't have them on display, you know. But I just got a thing for Imperials. I don't really know what it is. But, and then I got a bunch of Yodas. And then down here, I'm still working on the bottom. I don't have anything on my, I just got that last Jabba Throne yesterday. But you know, like in these, this is the only one that has chin guns on the bottom here, but I just slowly keep, you know, getting them. They're hard to find. You know, I try to look on the IC or whatever, and or any of the side groups. Over here, I've got all my parts bins. So it's all, you know, like the backs, I've got just tons of feet. These are all head parts. Those are all inside board bases, leg parts. So, and then here, I'll walk you over here. Well, this isn't really AT-AT stuff, but I laid it out to show you. This is some of my wax boxes stuff. Figured I'd show you that. And there's Star Wars everywhere, you know, handmade blanket for my mom. There's another one. I do have tons of Star Wars everywhere, like I was telling you on the side. I actually dragged those out for Halloween. Those are a couple of them Ben Cooper original Halloween masks. In fact, the one's actually pretty cool. It still says it's 99 cents. That's what they were back in the day. These are all Hallmark ornaments. I've got enough. I do my own Star Wars tree. I've got just bins of them. And then we were talking about this. So I got out all my boxes. So I do have a Jedi box, which is harder to find. There's a complete one in there. And then I've got the couple of the Empire boxes. And then believe it or not, I do have one modern. But I've got some, you know, sticker sheets are hard to find too. They're just like chin guns, man. They're like gold. And I had a guy that sent me this. Like I was telling you, I don't mind, you know, helping people in that. And he needs some cards for his collection. So he sent me these. It's kind of neat. It's just the, you know, the U.S. patent for the AT-AT. I thought it was pretty neat. I'm going to get them framed. And be pretty neat. And then like over here, I've just got, you know, some modern stuff. There's a couple shuttles, more stompers, you know, just newer stuff. And then I think I was telling you this. So my wife had this made for me. Each one of these is, you know, one of my tattoos. That's bad lighting, I think. Is that better?
Yeah. Wow, that's one of a kind, man.
Yeah, that's pretty neat. She had that made for me, so pretty neat.
That's awesome.
But, you know, and I've got just boxes of wax packs, and these are all loose, you know, loose cards. And a lot of the boxes of these in my collection are the are newer stuff or modern, you know.
Wow.
But like I was saying, you know, I mean, I got, you know, there's just a little bit everywhere. Like up there's an R2 and, you know, I've just got, there's just a little bit of Star Wars everywhere. Like here's, there's a alarm clock, a couple banks. This is actually a shower head.
R2-D2
shower head. Yeah, some people have never seen that. This was actually from my winning at Cozumel 2 on that MMC. But I just kind of got, you know, everywhere you look, it's kind of Star Wars.
Star Wars, yeah.
It's kind of, that's my...
Wow, that's super impressive, Mark. Well done, mate.
And I've actually got it. You just tell Alexa to turn on Star Wars, and it actually goes on. So
nice. Hey, I noticed that the Yoda army—they're all naked Yodas, yeah.
Yeah, that is. I don't know why. I've had people ask me that too. It sounds weird that you like naked Yodas, but I'd rather, I just think he looks better without that snake and stuff around his.
Yeah. No doubt. I mean, they're not like fully naked, so you're okay. But it's just kind of like, it's funny to see, you know, the whole army of Yoda without the brown, you know, clothing and the cape and the snake, as you mentioned.
There's one, like, you know.
Oh, there's one there, yeah.
Yeah, there's one. He's got a belt and a thing. But, like, with me, I don't even – here, I'll just flip the thing around while I'm talking to you quick. Mm-hmm. There we go. I don't even have like a full run. I kind of collect what I like, and you know, I mean, that's what it's about. Yeah. I mean, it's I actually saw a thing today, and not to keep referencing the IC, but there was a guy today that said, I don't think I fit this group, you know, and he said this and that because, you know, just a few of his opinions. And it was awesome to see all the guys that said, well, if you're collecting and it's what you like to do, and, you know, that's what we're here exactly. for. So why don't you fit the group? You know what I mean? So, you know, your collection's all about what you want. You know, I mean, if I've had people say, why so many AT-ATs? I don't know. I just, it's
an addiction. Yeah.
It's not a bad addiction. I mean, there, you know, you could have other bad addictions besides that. So, I just keep, you know, it keeps me out of trouble, put it that way.
Absolutely. And, in fact, you brought up a really good point about, fitting in a group and stuff, right? This is not about competition, you know, and that's my kind of, what I tell other collectors as well, you know, when they see like, whoa, like Harris, like your room is like grand. And I say, look, this is nothing. Like I can always compare myself with other collectors and yours, for example. But, you know, at the end of the day, we're all different, right? We all have different focuses. We have, different ways of, you know, how we want to collect and display them. So that's what's unique about each of us.
Right. It's just, you know, I mean, everybody can express themselves, you know, like tattoos. Some people say, why would you get them?
Exactly.
If I have a short sleeve shirt on, you don't see them. All of mine are up because some people are that judgmental. But then people see them and they're like, wow. I mean, it's, you know, it's just, I don't know. It's what I do. I don't know why somebody would get a picture of a whale on them or, you know what I mean? Or something like that. It's just, yeah. Me, it's just, you know, it's just kind of what makes me tick, I guess.
Absolutely. And I got to ask you, do you have an AT-AT tattoo?
I don't yet, but it's in the works. So
nice.
It's in the works. I say that because my tattoo guy, he moved to California. So I actually haven't had any ink since 2008. So wow. I've had all of the ones I have since 2008. So we're already talking because I've got an emperor tattoo. I'm going to meet Ian McDermott at the ICCC convention in Nashville. I bought my VIP pass. So I'm going to meet the emperor. So we're going to rework that. And then we're going to try and get some either a driver's helmet or an AT-AT. We're going to get somewhere in the collage before April.
Awesome, man. Awesome. Hey, by the way, thank you so much, Mark, for taking us through your room. That is just, again, freaking amazing, man. But to see the army of AT-ATs is such, for my eyes, it's just kind of popped and so unbelievable to see, you know. It's actually more than what the Imperial have deployed on Hoth. Right?
I think the picture you saw was actually the... was on the IC and what it was I had a little driver and he's looking at the collection and I just put the what Dak said, you know, I sometimes feel like I could take on the whole empire myself.
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, man, it's really amazing. And really, once again, thank you so much and well done, like, you know, for achieving what you have to a point as it is today. Well done, Mark.
I appreciate it. It's a work in progress. So maybe a year from now, there might not be much, or, you know, there might be a lot more. I don't know. I'm thinking about adding a room on the house and see what the wife says. So
nice. Time to negotiate.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Hey, Mark, let's jump into a rapid question, shall we?
Okay.
All right. So you did kind of mention it before about obsession, right? Do you think Star Wars collecting is an addiction? That's what I usually ask. But this time I'm going to kind of like tweak it a little bit different. Do you think AT-AT collecting is an obsession?
I guess I would say yes, because it's unique and I don't know a lot of people to do it. That's probably part of the catch, the allure for me, or whatever you want to say, is just because I don't know anybody that has 40 some AT-ATs. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Maybe that's why there is one collection I've seen a picture of And the guy does have more than me. I have seen it through being online in that. And that guy has quite a collection, but I don't know where he is or who he is.
Right, right. Okay. Next, what would you say is the most valuable piece from a sentimental value standpoint?
From sentimental, I would just say my two originals. I would never get rid of them. I would never, you know, I mean, they're played with. It's a Stormtrooper. It's yellow. I wouldn't even try and whiten it with peroxide or any of that stuff. I just wouldn't. You know, I would just leave it the way it is.
Mm. Cool. What would you say is your next big purchase?
Hoping that
your wife's not going to watch this.
Oh, well, I told you on the side, I do have one already in the works. At the ICCC, at the convention, I'm going to get a graffiti AT-AT I'm buying from an artist. Wow. He's only making 8 of them, and I will have a numbered one of those. I'd like to get a completely, you know, unopened Jedi AT-AT. That would be just, you know, a boxed, unopened. Doesn't have to be graded. We're not there yet. I'm not huge on the grading thing yet. I'll probably get there someday, but, you know, just the whole sealed, I don't have any sealed box. I don't have any. So, you know, either one, whether it's a Jedi box or a Empire Strikes Back, but that's on my list of, you know, goals, let's say.
Right. Well, those goals could be just a few days away or a few minutes away, right? So folks, if you do have one of those that Marc is seeking for, just make sure you reach out to him. All right. Marc, what would you say, again, not a silly question, what would you say is your favorite Star Wars movie?
Favorite Star Wars movie would be Empire Strikes Back, without a doubt.
There you go. Yeah, welcome to the 85% club of Star Wars collectors. They tend to love Empire Strikes Back, so there you go.
I do have a special place in my heart for Darth Maul, so if we can just watch the Darth Maul scenes from episode 1, that would be number 2, but I do have a place for him there. I can't believe they just got rid of him so quick in episode 1, but cool. I wish they'd do a 10 and bring him back with the spider legs like they did in the Clone Wars.
One last question. Does your wife keep a count on your edits?
No, my little boy does, and he tells my wife.
Oh, no.
he either tells her that there's more, or I'm the first one home with the boys, and they'll tell him that Daddy got another package in the mail today.
Nice.
No.
Anyway, your wife must have taught the boys really well.
She tries to keep it even, because, you know, there's Amazon and all that stuff that you can buy from. So yeah. I get the Star Wars packages, and she makes sure she gets one from Amazon or, you know, any of the other places. So
balance of the force.
We keep the mailman and the UPS guy pretty busy.
Awesome, man. All right. Hey, any last words just before we kind of close this off, Marc?
No, just to everybody collecting, just be yourself. Collect what you want to collect. Just because you get on the internet and you go on, you know, this site or that site, and I've got a bunch of AT-ATs, you know, just do your thing. You know what I mean? Like, and it's out there. Be patient. Don't be afraid to ask some of these people. You know, don't be afraid if you get in some of these groups, these Facebook groups or sites, or, you know, ask the people. I mean, you're gonna know if you ask a question and people light you up. Get out of there. That's not a group to stay in. I mean, you know, the people are out there. There is still good people. There is still good people out there. And it's a great community. The Star Wars community is, you know, I found is a pretty good place. I mean, there's a few local guys that I, you know, talk to at the flea market, or we're constantly tagging each other when something's for sale, because we know, you know, he likes that or I like this, or, you know, just have people help you. You know, if you help people, they'll help you. And I've tried to help people with, you know, a few things and card collections. They just need a few cards. I've got a pile of commons, you know, so
yeah,
they're all commons, I guess. But you know what I mean? I've got a pile of them. If I can, you know, they might not be mint, but if it can help them complete their set, you know, and that's another thing. Don't ever be afraid to, you know, if you want a power droid, you know, get that power droid, because there's always a better one out there. You know what I mean? So
yeah,
you may get it and it may be great and it's a 50 or whatever, but you can always look for something better. So don't ever pass up that moment to get what you want or what you've been searching for, just because it may have, you know, a little bit of damage or a creased card or something like that.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just how I learned, you know, there's always higher end, better stuff out there, you know, and it will come around. I mean,
yeah,
as people pass on, families get rid of collections, they don't know what they're worth, and, you know, or it just gets passed on. Some people just are done collecting, so they want to buy a new car and they start selling their collection, you know? So it's kind of always out there and it's kind of always recycling itself.
Yeah. No, definitely great advice there, Mark. Appreciate that. So folks, if you enjoyed that episode 53 with Marc Rosenberg, or the also known as the Adapt Man, give it a big thumbs up. If you haven't yet subscribed to our channel, please do so and hit that notification bell as well for future videos. So Mark, without further ado, I'd like to thank you once again for jumping on. And bloody well done with your Adapt collection, and I look forward to seeing, you know, your babies kind of like expanded to maybe 100 or even 200 of them in the next 12 months or so. Yeah, folks, I look forward to catching up with you guys on episode 54. May the force be with you, Mark, and may the force be with you all.
Thanks, Harris. May the force be with you.